Okay, students. So now the mock number one. So students, now the first thing when you are going to do the answer for the mock number one, I am specifically telling students you should be very much understanding the requirement. The question requirement understanding is very much crucial, because students, many people lose their marks without knowing the requirement. Now, for example, students, I will say that as framing. Initially, we need to do the framing. That is, understand what the examiner really wants in a question. So firstly, evaluate. So the verb is evaluate. Evaluate is not a small verb, actually. It's one of the highest level verb that they generally ask. The reputation risk. So reputation risk. So students, be very much careful. Evaluate the reputation risk. But you should never go into the theory section, because let's see the next verb what they are using. Associated with this issue. So we do not know the issue and how should be identified in advance. So one is evaluate reputation risk, associated with issue, with this issue, not the normal issue, whatever they are given. So students, in the exams, some students who memorizes, they will generally go through this point. They have in this question, there is a risk table. I think that is there in page number 14. Some students will go through this. Please don't go through this. You need to go through the situation what they're asking. Okay? Evaluate the reputation risk associated with this issue. That is one. And comma. And there is a separate element. And how this should have been identified in advance. So they're asking how this should have been identified in advance. Should have been identified in advance. Just keep in mind, students, how this should have been identified in advance. Okay. And managed before this has become viral in the social network. So identified and managed. So this is the two sections in one question. So students, if you look at this question, it has two parts. So in the examination, the total marks for one question. Can someone tell me, Jaybal, what is the total marks for one question in an exam? Total marks for one question in an exam. How much are 33? You getting? 33 marks. So I'll just mention here 33 marks. So 1 mark I can say for integration. So I can generally make it 16 marks for one area. So I'll say 16 marks. So if you see this part A, it is 16 marks. So students, what I can generally say is I can break this into two sections. That is 8 marks for the section A. And also I can write it here as how much, students? 8 marks for the section B. 8 marks for the section A, 8 marks for the section B in the part A requirement. So I'll come to the secondly. Let's see the framing for the secondly also. So recommend with action the strategy we should have followed to minimize the impact of this issue before it become a legal offense. So students, here it is recommend with action. Okay, strategy. We need to develop some strategy before this has become a legal option. So again, I can say it is 16 marks once again. 16 marks once again. Okay. So students, now if you see here, we have not yet gone through the case study. We have not gone through the question. We went through the requirement first. So without going through the question, without going through the case, we went through the requirement. And still, students, we were able to understand something. So what we need to do now is we need to go through the case study so that it will give you the answer properly structured. So students, in your exams, just keep in mind, your answers should be blended into 4 areas. So what are the 4 areas, students, that is tested in the examination? 4 areas. One is the technical. One is the technical. Then business. You have what, students? Business. Very good. Business. Then we have the people skill. And the last one we have is the leadership skill. Okay, leadership skill. So students, in my exam class, what I'm going to do is the business skill I'm going to teach you with a color code of red color, and the people skill I'm going to color code it into the color code of green color, and the leadership skill I will color code it in the color code of blue color. So I'll just let you know that these are the color codes that we are generally using. So students, when we are structuring the answer, you will be knowing how I am structuring. So the hoverboard, Alan Peter. Can someone tell me who is Alan Peter? Alan Peter, the a person who has sent you.
Operation
director. So I'll just mention here operation director. So please be careful, students. You should remember the names of the people also. Okay, Alan Peter has sent you the following mail. The hoverboard of our company, which is old, we are unable to recycle. So it's a business issue. Yes or no? Recycling. Yes, recycle. Complete business issue. Recycling is a business issue. It's a business issue. And they are telling, and the batteries are causing some environmental impact and the plastic wheels too. So I can say the battery is causing some environmental impact and the wheels are also causing some environmental impact. So students, just keep in mind, at the moment this issue has become light to the people in Geeland. So I'll just mention people, the public, the general public has understood they are struggling with this, okay? And currently this has become viral in the social network. So don't specify Facebook, Twitter, everything. Just social network is more than enough, okay? Don't go to real life in detail. Please be kind enough to send the following. The reputation risk. So I'll just mention here technical strategy. I can say reputation risk. Reputation risk. Reputation risk. Reputation risk associated with this. We need to check how we are going to manage this. Okay. First one is evaluate the reputation risk and how. Identified in advance. Identified in advance. Not now. Identified in advance. Okay. So students, now let's come to the point here. Let's come to the point here. So the first point I just need to say is answer. I'll write down here answer. So I will just mention here as reputation risk associated. Reputation, I'll just mention here heading. Reputation risk. Reputation risk associated with hoverboard recycling. So just keep in mind, students, this is the reputation risk associated with hoverboard recycling. So students, now listen carefully. So students, now the reputation risk is very much clear for you all. So I'll just mention here, reputation risk, just for the purpose, is the risk that is affecting the brand identity and the goodwill of an entity. Brand identity and goodwill of what, students? An entity. Brand identity and goodwill of an entity. Come on. Now students, if you don't mind, can you tell me when was our company founded, students? When was our company founded? Runabout was founded in which year?
2005.
Now students, now in future when you are writing the examination, this speed, when I ask you about runabout, your company, you should do it very faster. You can't think in the exam what about this. Already data is there. So I'm going to mention here, runabout was incorporated in 2005. Till date, they have a good reputation in the market. Good reputation in the market. So students, this clearly explains how it works out. Good reputation in the market. Come on. Okay, I will just continue with the next one. The management also has maintained good stewardship function. Maintain good stewardship function. Stewardship function. Among the stake shareholders. Among the shareholders. Good stewardship function among the shareholders. Among the shareholders. Come on, leadership skill. Leadership skill. This has resulted the organization to get listed in the local stock market in the year 2010. So students, this is a reputation risk basic explanation associated to the company, to Alan, just to give it to the Alan so he can forward this also. So students, are you clear with what I'm saying?
Yes.
Okay, so students, now I'm going to evaluate the reputation risk associated with this, how it will affect the company. So students, I'll mention here as share price. What's the first thing I'm going to mention, students? Share price. Now my question to you all is our company a listed company? Yes or no?
Yes,
we are a listed company. Yes. And one very poor thing that I noted is no one has mentioned anything about this beta factor. The company is in a high risk profile area, because students, if you generally see, if something happen in reputation risk, since that beta factor is very high, now the share price is almost touching $14. Okay, almost touching $14 G dollars. But can this fall very quickly? Yes or no? Because of this beta factor. Yes or no, students? Because negative reputation will ultimately result in a reduction in the share price also. What do you think, students? Practically, yes or no?
Yes.
So students, that is the first thing that you need to think in the point of a businessman. Again, think commercially. Never think academically. Again, the golden rule to pass the strategic case study. You should think commercially. Commercially means like doing a business. Don't think like doing an exam. Academically, if you think, you will find it very hard. So I can generally say reputation impact may have a reduction in the share price of an entity. Basic technical explanation. Basic technical explanation. Fine. So students, I can say the share price of which company, student? The share price of Runabout. The share price of Runabout is currently trading at how much? Currently trading at how much? $14. Yes or no? Currently trading at $14. Okay. Currently trading at $14. So within brackets, I'll mention pre-seen page 20. Pre-seen page what, students? Page 20. Now in the exam, this is not relevant to write it. I'm just writing it so that in future, when you are referring this, you will be able to look at this. So I'll still continue. Further, the beta factor is more than one. Is more than what? One. Which signifies high systematic risk. High what risk, students?
Systematic risk.
Now, students, if you generally see, there are two types of risk. One is systematic risk. One is unsystematic risk. Now, unsystematic risk is the business risk, internal risk. But systematic risk means external risk. Now, here, the external risk is very high because highly compliance-based industry. Okay?
signifies high systematic risk. Come on. So I'll just continue with the people. The shareholders may perceive this social media trending as a threat to their personal image. Therefore, they may sell their existing shareholding. Okay. So leadership skill. This may result in the company to have less financing cash flow for upcoming projects. Full stop. Now students, this is one way of writing. So students, that is the basic risk associated here, because this negative reputation will definitely affect the share price. What do you think, students? Yes or no?
Yes.
So students, can you make a note in your workbook, whatever you have? The first thing, you have completely ignored this. Yes or no? No one mentioned this. Second thing, you have not mentioned this also. Now, I don't believe like you are a real life finance manager in this organization. Because if you are a real life finance manager, you should be very much bothered about the share price, what is happening. Yes or no, student?
Yes.
Because here you have not mentioned anything, whatever they have given, you have just given the general point. So Asif, also be very careful. Your answer structuring was very good. But the only problem is nothing related to the application. Application, this was not there. Beta factor is not there. So that is the major thing that you all need to improve in the next mock. And again, telling students, it will take around 8 mocks to improve your standard. We will continue this. You don't worry. But first 8 mocks is unlearning process, because you would have learned in a different style. But in this session, we are going to learn the unlearning process. So students, now next one, we can come here. So I can generally say after share price, I can just come to the next one here. As I can say yes. Compliance risk. So I'll write down here compliance risk. So I'll just write down with the heading compliance risk. So students, basic introduction of what is compliance risk, a technical answer. So I'll just say compliance risk is the risk associated with the regulations of a region. So students, I'll just mention here. So I can say, in what is our country, students? Name of our country.
In G land,
currently there are some regulations for the commuters. Using bicycle or scooters to wear
helmets.
Okay, come on. And also I can say, at present, Runabout is the only company to have permit to provide
hoverboard service. To provide what service, students? Hoverboard service. So, students, I'll just come here. If the recycling is causing environmental damage, the environmental regulation body, the environmental regulation body in Zealand, will be able to fine penalties to the company. And I'll come to the leadership point, and I'll just mention the blue color. There is high risk that in future we may lose the permit to operate in Zealand because of our poor recycling practice. Full stop. So, students, I am generally asking you, will this be also a major factor that is affecting? What do you think, student? Yes or no? So, Jaybal, thank you. So, students, I think that this is how you should be very much specific, students. Very much specific in the answer. And I never saw no one mention that this also. We are the only company to have permit now. I told you, now if you are not revising your pre-seen, you will fail the exam. Honestly, a very straightforward answer. If you are not doing the pre-seen, sure fail in the answer. You know E3, P3, F3, 100% knowledge. You don't know the case study, fail. That is the exam norm here. So take it as serious, students. Remember all these things like you are working in this organization. So share price, compliance risk. Okay. So students, now the next thing I can generally think is, another risk is very much. So just a minute. Okay. So I'll just come back. So the next point is risk from commuters shifting to bicycle instead of hoverboard. Instead of what? Hoverboard. Now, students, if you see these countries in the Europe, I generally feel so, they are very much concerned. Now, if you are telling this is dangerous, they will slowly not use that product. So there is a high risk that the customers, the commuters can shift to bicycle from hoverboard. They'll think if we consume this hoverboard, it is causing damage to our environment. So let's shift to the bicycle instead. So I'll just mention here the switching cost. So I'll just say the switching cost is the risk where the customer switches to a substitute product, Basic explanation. Switches to a substitute product. Okay. So students, that clearly gives you the basic understanding here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to continue this. I'm going to say, okay, the Business Inc. The main substitute for
hoverboard for hoverboard is bicycle and scooters. At present, the hoverboard or any other micro mobility transport mode is very inexpensive, very cheap. That means very cheap. Therefore, the company will face high risk of customers changing the hoverboard to another transport, Come on. Now, students, I'll just come here. The people. So I can generally say here, the commuters should be aware of the solutions that is developed by Runabout. Solution that is developed by Runabout. And I'll come to the leadership part. This needs to be clearly communicated to the commuters through the mobile app or their emails. That is one way you need to secure the commuters, the risk of commuters. So just keep in mind, students, this is one more factor that you need to consider. So students, can you tell me some other factors that is associated with here? So can you remember, students, I'll just show you, you would have not even thought about this. Now, if you see here that Doc Bike is currently teaching IT in a university, that is the capital university of capital city. So students, can there be a solution developed by our competitor? Yes or no? Can yes. The university students of our competitor develop renewable batteries, and can they take the competitive advantage and win all the licenses, everything? Yes or no?
Yes,
this is practical, student. This happens everywhere. Everywhere this happens, students. So I'll just mention here. Now, that mind should work on the exam day. That is my concern here. So I'll just mention Doc Bike. I'll write down Doc Bike developing renewable battery using students at
University
of Capital City. So students, that is a high risk, a disruption, we say. I can say it's a disruption. So I'll write down here. Disruption is the development that
is changing the normal usage pattern. Normal usage pattern. Usage pattern in the market. In the market. Come on. Now, students, I will continue with the application, that is the red color ink. I can generally say DocBike can develop renewable batteries from the university, of capital city. Okay, and I'll come to the people. This can be done with the support of the existing university students. So I'll come to the leadership point. I can say this can impact runabout very high, since DocBike will be able to win all the government contracts, comma, further, this will be a product made in Zealand, where the local population will be attracted to use it, resulting in poor financial performance to run about.
So students, these are the four major area that we have written. So four major subheadings. So I can say eight marks here. So this is done. Four major area, 8 marks here. Already done. So students, any questions with this area what we have developed? Any questions? If you're okay with that, you can put Y in the comment box. Any questions you can ask, please. So thank you, Mr. Kiran, thank you, Jayabal, thank you, Arib, thank you, Matlub, Asif, I think you are fine, you can put Y in the comment box. Can we mention potential revenue loss? Yes, we have already mentioned that because poor financial performance. We can write that, but I think we have written everything that is essential here. Share price, revenue loss, everything. So students, just keep in mind, students, this paper is very, very practical, very, very practical. So your answers, what you are developing also must be very much practical. So students, I will come to the next section. The next section is how this issue can be identified in advance and managed. Okay, I can just write down. That is the part B of the first one. How to identify this issue in advance. First one I can write down here as pilot testing.
pilot what students? Testing. Now my question here, currently do we have a pilot testing or we directly run it in our country? Do we have a pilot testing or we directly use the machinery, this hoverboard in our country? Just asking.
Direct.
Direct. Yeah. You buy from Minering, directly put it to the customer. So that itself clearly shows that we don't have this. So that's a huge risk we are currently facing. So I can say it's a basic introduction. Pilot testing is a demo run before the product is introduced to the market. Come on, that is the pilot run. So I'll just come here. At present, Runabout does not have any pilot run. Runabout does not have what? Any pilot run. And merely trusting the past evidence of Minering. That is the main issue. You are just trusting Minering. Yes or no, students? Agree?
Yes.
You are just trusting the Minering brand. Okay. So I can write down here. Now, operation director, I can say Alan could have. Mm-hmm. Alan could have developed a small team to test the product before it is launched launch to the market. Comma, I can still continue. I can say further the pilot testing results needs to be documented so that if there is any issues, then the evidences can be presented. Evidences can be presented. So that is one of the major issue that we need to improve in the future. But if this we had, we could have just presented to Minering in this form. So any problems with that, students?
So Nufil, this pilot testing is, does it address the point of a product completing its life cycle and then this battery issue coming up, right?
Yes. Now, for example, Mr. Kiran, now they have a battery overheating problem. So even that itself, you can understand in the pilot testing that a life cycle pilot testing. Are you understanding, Mr. Kiran? Because this will last only for about 6 months, if I'm not mistaken. This whole board. It will not be lasting for 5 years or 2 years. So within 6 months means the pilot testing needs to be conducted anyway before it is launched. I think Mr. Kiran, Nano had an issue. It was burning. Tata Nano. Yeah. Some places. Main issue is pilot testing they did not do for the full product. Are you understanding what I'm saying? Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So there should be documentation, nothing done, and they have just released it to the market. So that will cause a big issue. And Mr. Kiran, now what is our company's like it's a new company, it's now a bit older, 15 years old.
15 years.
So if it is 15 years old, that means this issue has been already there, but they have been hiding this. What do you think, Mr. K?
Yeah.
Because that is an ethical issue also, indirectly. What do you think here? Because it's a very old company, but they are now only coming into the light that there's a recycling issue.
Yeah, I mean, in the sense, hoverboard was introduced in 2016. So effectively, yeah, this has been there for last 4 years.
Last 4 years. So every 6 months, they would have replaced it.
Replaced,
but yeah. But without recycling. I think that would have the problem that would have caused now in 2020.
Hmm.
So I will just come to the next one in advance. One is pilot testing. Other one I can just mention is requesting after sales service from Minering. From which company? Minering. Now, my question, students, do we have after sales service here at this point?
No.
No, we do not have after sales service. That means we are directly buying and we are just giving it to the consumer. So when some problem takes place in the market, what happens is you are only liable for everything. What do you think, Mr. Kiran? Yes or no? No after sales service at all.
Yeah.
So I can say after sales service is one of the primary activities of the value chain, of the what chain? Value chain. Now, students, did I memorize and write value chain, or did I just reference value chain for a situation?
Reference.
So students, this is not brain dumping. This is, I'm developing the point. Okay, students. So I'm going to continue this. So I will write down with a red color pen, that is our application. So I can say at present, we do not have any after sales service provided by Minering to runabout. We do not have any after sales to runabout. Now, students, I'll just complete this. So I can say, now, do we have anyone for marketing? No, we do not have anyone for marketing. So again, I need to say, you can ask a Geo patron. I can just mention Geo patron can negotiate. Look at the verb I'm using. Negotiate with Minering by presenting the future requirement we need, and asking for a recycling facility by returning the hoverboards back to Minering and getting a discount in the next procurement. So students, now if you see some good companies, they will ask their items back. And they will give discounts because ultimately plastic, once again, they will be using for the new one also. The new hoverboard also, they may need plastic. So they may ask their old one and they will give you some discount. But here there is nothing like that. The leadership skill, I can just say, this is the blue color one. So I'll just mention this could have prevented the recycling issue. Provided if formal agreements formal agreements has been signed? Formal agreements has been what, students? Signed. Do they have any formal agreements signed?
No
agreements have been signed. So that is one issue here. Pilot testing requesting after sale service of Minering. Okay. And then, students, there is something called I think this was written by one student but not explained. Outsourcing the what, students?
Recycling
function. Outsourcing, yes. The recycling function. So some student has written that, but they have not explained this. That is the issue. The writing was there, the explanation was not there. Now my question is, can we outsource the recycling function? Practical or not practical, students? Yes, sir. Practical. There are organizations who generally will have recycling functions. So I can generally write down a brief understanding. Outsourcing is the process where the company would transfer the obligations to a third party. So I can continue this. I can say Runabout could have outsourced the recycling function to a third party specialist. So I'll continue this. Alan could have evaluated some recycling companies before the operations have commenced. Before the operations have what, students? Commenced. So I'll just continue. However, at present, still they can have a tender for a recycling partner. And they can use this recycling process for non-financial reporting. For what reporting? For non-financial reporting, so that the reputation can be maintained. Students, any problems with the outsourcing function?
Yes.
No. Students, that is how you need to do the outsourcing part. So one is pilot testing, requesting after sales service for Minering, outsourcing to a recycling function. That is the third one. And the fourth one, I can generally say here is the recycling. So in order to prevent this, one more action that you could have done in future is consider alternative hoverboard service provider. Now currently, are we over dependent on Minering? Yes or no?
Yes.
Now, if we had alternative service providers, we would have at least some control. What do you think, students? Yes or no? We would have at least some control. Yes or no, students? So I'll just come here. I can write down. There can be many suppliers so that the process is not affected. Come on. So I'll continue with that. Over dependent on mirroring is a key weakness since we don't get any other additional services. So students, I'll continue here. I can say Alan could have done some industry research on other service providers so that we could have identified some replaceable battery hoverboard. Come on. So I'm going to continue this. I'm going to say the leadership point. This strategy would have eliminated the over dependency on one supplier, and further we could have secured the brand image. So students, we are done with the part A requirement. So any questions you all have, please feel free to let me know. So students, anything you need to ask, please let me know. I will definitely help you. If you're okay with that explanation, you can put Y in the comment box. Thank you. Thank you, Jaybal. Thank you, Amir. Thank you. So students, now what we will do next is the recommend with the actions, the strategy. So students, now should we have elaborate all skills or something can be missed? Frankly speaking, better to go with all the skills. Don't go with something can be missed. You will not be able to pass. That's what we need to practice a lot. So students, secondly, recommend with action the strategy we should have followed to minimize the impact of this issue before it becomes a legal issue. So students, my question here is, at the moment in the market, we are the only provider of hoverboard service. And we are the only company that is providing this service, and currently, we are the only company who are having this recycling issue.
So the current strategy here, it's we risk accept. You need to accept the risk anyway. Then at least you will have the respect in the market. At least you are accepting we did not have a proper recycling plan. In future, we will be having. So the first thing you need to do is recommend is accept what has already happened. Yes or no? You can't blubber in the market saying, no, not like that, not like that. It accept it. Sorry, it's our mistake. So we will be improving this in the future. That is how a high level professional acceptance must be there. So students, I will just come here. So I will just mention here as a heading. So I can just mention the part B. That is, I can say strategies to minimize the impact. Strategies to minimize the impact of battery recycling. So first thing I will just mention here as a risk word. Risk word, students. Risk accept. Okay, so I'll just mention risk accept. So I'll just write down, this is the strategy, students. You can't play the fool here with the government, okay? Risk accept is where an organization takes responsibility for the past events and they manage it well in the future. Full stop. Well in the future. Tara is a knowledge dumping. You can't mention. I put value chain. Now value chain, I just mentioned what is the level. You can write Tara matrix full here. That is like very basic level. Here you should reference what I'm saying. So I'm just mentioning risk accept. So I can generally say here, since we are the only service providers for hoverboard in GLAND, it is better to accept our fault. It's better to accept our fault. I'll continue. I can just say, Alan needs to identify the alternative strategies to minimize this impact. Okay, comma, I can generally say this will definitely have a good reputation in the future. Since we are not blaming anyone. And we are correcting ourselves. We are correcting ourselves. It's a very difficult question. Don't worry about students, ourselves. So that is one strategy here. So the next strategy is, okay, communicate to the government. Now, students, you need to speak to the government before this. Yes, son. Communicate to the government. Very much important, students. That is one strategy with action. After you accept it, you should communicate to the government. We are sorry this has happened. So we need to improve our changes. So just I'll mention here, I can just say, government is a key
satisfied stakeholder. Is that what students? Keep satisfied stakeholder. Can someone tell me from where is this knowledge I am taking from? It's a key.
Mendelian matrix.
Mendelian matrix. But did I dump Mendelian matrix or I applied Mendelian matrix?
Applied.
Applied. So that is the change that you need to have in your presentation. So here I can say the government of Zealand is splitted into both central government and local government. Central government and local government. The government needs to be informed of the issue since we are the only service provider. We are the only service provider. Only service provider. Only service provider. So I can generally say now government is a big organization. So generally I can write that. I can just mention since the government is the only service provider, I can generally say that the people, Alan is the operation director. So I will ask a non-executive director. I can say in the non-executive, I can say Marco Palomo. So can someone tell me who is Marco Palomo? Who is Marco Palomo?
NED, known as
NED, in charge for what? NED in charge for what? NED in charge for what? So this is the problem you will have in the exam if you do not know the pre-scene material. NED in charge for what, students? Risk committee and audit committee. He is in charge for risk committee and audit committee. So this is actually a risk actually at the moment. So Marco Palomo, the NED in charge for the risk committee needs to communicate to the government officials before they identify. Come on. So I'll just continue this. This may reduce the penalty. This may reduce the penalty and increase the transparency. Since there are how many employees working in our organization, students?
15,000.
Since there are 15,000 employees working in the organization, there can be possibilities government assistance can be obtained. Such as a recycling facility. Full stop. So students, is this a good strategy? Yes or no, students? Communicate yes, to the yes. Government.
Yes, yes.
Yes, because we have this 15,000 employees. So students, do you understand the importance of the pre-seen material, students? Yes or no?
Yes.
It is helping yes. You to work for that company. Okay, it's helping you to work for that company. So the next one I can say is after government, you can communicate to the media. You can communicate to what, students? In the media. What do you think, students? Is it better, yes or no? Initially, get government assistance and then speak to the media. So I can say, media is a keep informed stakeholder. What do you think, students? Yes or no? Keep informed what, students? Stakeholder. Okay, so I can say the company can use their official accounts, to communicate in the social media platform. The company can use their official accounts to communicate in the social media platforms. Further, they can use the print media to communicate in a very formal manner, to the market, further, the app can be used to provide information to the existing, how many users we have, students? How many accounts we have?
30 million plus.
30 million plus? Mm-hmm. Correct. It is 30 million. Just I'll take it down. So students, don't mention 30 million plus. It's very vague. When you're a manager in this organization, you don't know this, it will be a big issue. So I'll just mention here, I think that is there. We have already gone through that. So here they would have mentioned, I think it is 30,270,000 users. Existing 30,270,000 users. Yes or no, students? Can you use your app to communicate? Yes. So I can just mention, can you tell me who is Jack Avery?
Chairman.
So I'll just mention, here chairman should come into the picture. Jack Avery should be able to make a statement. Jack Avery should be able to make a statement to the market in a very responsible manner. Responsible manner. Comma. And explain the actions that has been taken to prevent this issue. By disclosing evidences. By disclosing evidences. Full stop. Students, the media communication looks fine before it becomes a legal issue. Okay. And final one, I can just mention, get legal, students?
Advice.
So students, I think I made a mistake. I actually, legal advice should come before you communicate to it. Media, what do you think, students? Yes or no, students? So yeah. I will mention here, get legal advice. Is it okay, students? Yes or no?
Yes.
The good thing of doing the exams in the computer is when you are getting a point, which should be in the future, you can just do what I did now. You get the points, students. Yes or no? Because yes. Students, practically speaking, after you communicate to the government, then better to take a legal advice and then communicate to the media. What do you think, students? Yes or no? Yes. So I'll just mention yes. here. Legal advice. So I'll just mention here. Legal advice is very essential. It's very, what, student? Essential. So I can see. Since GLAND is a regulated entity, is what, students? A regulated entity. There needs to be high rules and regulation. High rules and what? High rules and what? Regulations. Come on. So I just continue with the next point, okay? So I can generally say, as now, if you see here, I can use the person Patrick. Again, Patrick I can use. Who is Patrick Cha? Patrick Cha, can someone tell me?
NED.
NED, in charge for what, students? In charge for what, Patrick Church? Now see, you have not studied that. You have time, but you should be very much knowledgeable here, because most of you all are not doing this first time. You have already done this. So now you should target a good rank now, not a pass only. Patrick Cha, who is that, students? Can someone tell me? What is he in charge? NED in charge for what? There is a small line going. You can check and see. Patrick Cha, in charge for what? Remuneration and risk. He's for remuneration and risk. So I'll mention Patrick Cha, the NED for risk, should be able to explain to a good legal firm about our situation, comma, I can say the leadership skill, the legal advisor should be able to provide examples of other incidents which was similar to the current issues we have. And help the organization to develop better control procedures. So students, again telling, this is the practical point. So students, these are the strategies what we need to say. So before it becomes before it becomes a legal offense, the first thing is risk accept is the first thing. So any questions, please feel free to ask.
First, Ellen Peter also deal with legal issues.
Yes, because he's in the risk committee. So risk people, yes, can go to the legal sector because they may have some experience, non-executive. Because executive is going to the legal and the government, the respect will be little less because they are very working class. But the people who are in the non-executive are generally retired people, almost going to retire. Expert, I must pushing them to go out and talk. So students, I think any questions you have, feel free to ask. But I think students, the weakness of your answer was it was not aligning with the case study. You get what I'm saying, sir? Hello?
Yes.
That was the major issue. Now see, if you look at this, I'm putting only black color ink for a small introduction. You won't get much mark. But I'm focusing mostly on, like, I am inside Glandia. I'm working for this organization. So students, in future, when you are writing the answer, I think I would have already sent you the mock 2. So when you're doing the mock 2, students, please write in color code. You get what I'm saying? Please write the color code. It will be very much better. And if you are writing in black, fully fine. But before you send it to me, you color code it. Then you will understand what is your weakness, what skill you are lagging at. You need to skill-wise improve. And one more thing, students, if possible, before you do the answer, do a proper framing. Framing is very much crucial, students. Framing is very much crucial. And one thing I can tell you, students, this exam you can pass like passing an English paper. If you are very good with comprehension and the pre-seen material, you are going to give practical solution rather than pre-learned solution. Are you clear with what I'm saying, students? Hello?
Yes, sir.
So students, now the mock number 2, I have emailed it to you and I have put the deadline also. Please send it to me. And after you send it to me, again, I'll try to send you another mock. Because students, I told you, we will be having the triple session class, not from this week, the coming week. So this week I have some other class. So we will be having our class from 1st May, the 1st May. But during this 4 days time period, is it possible? Can you do the mocks what I'm sending you? Yes or no, student?
Hello? Yes.
Yes. And the next thing, students, I will be sending you another document by tomorrow, a ratio analysis document. That means the ratios what we have already calculated, you should explain why there is a change in the ratio and what can be the future impact. Can you do a small assignment like that? Yes or no, students? And then I will help you on that. So we have already done the SWOT analysis. And we are going to do the ratio analysis and then we are doing the mocks. So it gets familiar to the business. Now, for example, students, when you do around 8 mocks, what happens is you will know the names of the people working in our organization. Yes or no? Correct or not correct? Like today we know Alan is our director of operations. Correct?
Yes.
So like 8 mocks, you will get familiar with everything. Writing, learning. And you will be familiar with the people also. Currently, we have 15,000 people working in our organization. 30 million people. You can memorize this. This comes by practice. And our share price is $14. I think you will never forget this information. And in the next mock also, what I'm sending, please don't write brain dumping knowledge. Don't copy the same point once again that is written. Write it differently, little practically. Okay, Matlub? So I think, students, any questions you have for today's session? I'll just have around 30 seconds. Thank you, Matlub. So Mr. Kiran, any questions? Mr. Jayabal, any questions?
Mr. Nifil, can you just scroll down a bit? Your answer, reputation risk associated with our board. Yeah, sorry. So, no. The first piece of your answer. Compliance risk, I wonder. Yeah.
Compliance risk.
I'm just thinking because it talks about evaluate the reputation risk associated with this issue and we are talking reputation is issue, so risk. I'm just thinking if it fits in.
No. Now see here, evaluate the reputation risk associated with this issue. Now, for example, compliance risk is a reputation risk. Are you understanding, Mr. Kiran?
Non-compliance is a reputation risk. You mean?
Non-compliance is the reputation risk. But compliance risk, okay, I can make it non-compliance risk. Fine. That's good. I can make it non-compliance. Is it okay? Because what happens is reputation has multi-connections. Yes or no, Mr. Kiran? Hello? Okay. So, Jaybal, any questions you have?
No, sir.
Jaybal, one thing I need to say, your answer quality which must improve very much, okay?
Okay.
Just keep in mind, Jaybal, not good for the current standard.
Mm-hmm.
Ask if your answer structuring was good. Only thing is, it should be aligned to the requirement. So students, I think everything is fine. So can we have the session on Friday?
Sure, sir.
Sure. Take care. Take care.